Hello, my name is Father Howard Giles here at Jesus the Good Shepherd Anglican Church in Henderson, Nevada. Today is Wednesday, August the 7th, 2019, and I'm here at Jesus the Good Shepherd just to show you around a little bit so that you know a little bit about where we worship. This is our wall that features the leadership of our church. Our bishop is Bishop Eric Manise. Our archbishop is Archbishop Foley Beach. Our former bishop, retired and then now deceased, Reverend John David Schofield. And this is him at GAFCON in Jerusalem. And then our former archbishop, Bob Duncan, still serving in the Diocese of Pittsburgh. Our vision and mission statement, purpose, mission, and vision is here on the wall from Ezekiel 34. We will seek the lost, bring back the misled, bind up the broken, strengthen the fallen, protect the strong, and feed them with judgment. This is where we serve coffee hour here in our narthex, just at our front door of our building. We have the icon that usually is our Jesus the Good Shepherd icon, but because yesterday was the Feast of the Transfiguration, we feature that. It gives our people a chance to focus as soon as they come into the sanctuary or as they're entering the sanctuary on the worship of our Lord and of the feast days and his saints. So we do have coffee hour after both of our services. This is where we generally have coffee and tea and water. Our missions board is being worked on by several of our members, but you can see some of the places that we support with our tithes and offerings and sign-up sheets for all the different missions and ministries in our church. This is our library. It is the Father George and Judy Girard Memorial Library. And here we have lots of different materials for study. We have the first series of the Anti-Nicene Fathers, and we have all kinds of encyclopedias and concordances, resources for our Bible study and just for our people to take. We have a large library of different translations of the Holy Scriptures. We do read from the English Standard Version of the Bible on Sunday. We like to make audio Bibles available for those that may have difficulty with reading, and there's lots of other materials that we have for study. We have maps, especially maps of the Bible lands, and so during our Bible study every Saturday morning, we might look at the various maps as we're studying the scriptures. So this is where we meet every Saturday at 8 a.m. It's just kind of a living room environment, and people come and go as they can. You don't have to stay the whole time. It's 8 till 9 every Saturday. It's very informal. We just go one verse at a time. We have two restrooms, and they are handicap accessible restrooms. You can see that they have handbars, and the sinks are accessible. We always have stools for the children, a place to sit and rest. Speaking of children, we don't have Sunday school or a place where children have to go, but if parents would like their children to be able to rest and play, mothers or fathers, grandparents come in and play with the toys, and they can come in for, you know, part of the service or all of the service. It really depends on the family and the age of the child, what it is that they want to do. We do have a second bathroom. This is our office, not very interesting, so I won't show all of that. But our second restroom features one of my favorite things, which is our changing table. So we do have a couple of diapers just in case, but of course parents want to bring their own. But we do have the changing table available for those families that need that. And so now we'll go ahead and go back into the narthex, which is what we call our lobby, where people enter. Then we come into the sanctuary, where we have the Sanctus, holy, 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 above. And as you walk in, you'll see the basin for holy water. And this is the table where our bulletins are kept. So we have the announcements for that Sunday and the readings. We have all kinds of materials describing Anglicanism and the rule of life that we hand out that has a list of the things that we encourage all of our members to participate in. We do have live music. We have a pianist that plays every Sunday, and we play traditional hymns, and we play contemporary songs and sing. Our whole service is printed out in these binders, and And all of our music is available here too. So we have them on multicolored sheets, as you can see. So we always announce page numbers and use the colors of the binders for that. We do take an offering every Sunday, and that just goes by you. If you want to put something in, you can. But nobody, of course, is required to, and there's no pressure to give. We do make that opportunity for tithing, though. We give out these brochures and cards to people that visit our mite boxes, where we support some overseas ministries through the almsgiving of the church. Our sanctuary has these chairs. We have about 90 seats, and we probably average around 30 people per service. And so, children are always welcome, and families with children. This is where the lay people read the scriptures every Sunday. The altar would be set with candles and books and things for Holy Communion every Sunday. This is the tabernacle, where we keep Holy Communion that's in reserve. And so if we have the bread and the wine that we're going to reserve, we keep it here in the tabernacle. Our processional cross and our lighters and our Sanctus bells, and our clergy sit here at this seat to lead the people in worship, and our acolytes as well. The sanctuary is decorated because we don't have stained glass windows. We use icons to tell the story. So you'll see icons like this one featuring the baptism of Jesus. And then we have the stations of the cross. So here's the last one, where Jesus is laid in the sepulcher. And you can see that it's number 14. So you can see the passion story in pictures, which is very helpful for teaching children. One other place I thought I would show you is where we keep our vestments, and where we have all of our materials for Holy Communion and decorating the altar, our vases, and all of the linens that are needed and the tools that are needed for Holy Communion, our baptismal font and paschal candle. So this is some place where we keep all of those materials. It's called our sacristy, but it's a place where our people come and prepare to worship the Lord. So this is Jesus the Good Shepherd Anglican Church in Henderson, Nevada. My name is Father Howard Giles, and you will put a smile on my face if I see you in one of these seats. And I hope that someday soon we get to meet you and to worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and to receive him in the sacrament of his body and blood.